Hey boy, hey girl, how about we make us an Elvis sandwich? That was requested sometime back by one of my subscribers, so let's make one. We'll talk about it first or after. Okay, we talk about it now. There's a lot of variations of it. Elvis's mom stated in a book, whole lot of shaking going on. No, I had to say that. Elvis's mom stated in a book that Elvis used to like to eat them with bacon, bananas, peanut butter, sometimes jelly, sometimes not. Sometimes grape jelly, sometimes honey, sometimes blueberry jelly or jam. And the bread was always fried in either butter or bacon grease. Elvis preferred the bacon grease better, but his mom said, no, That's online. You can find all this information. And there's a bunch of other variations of it. Some of them will have it, will state that Elvis likes smashed bananas on a sandwich. Some of them will say that Elvis liked bananas sauteed in butter on the sandwich. Some like just sliced bananas, peanut butter on buttered, griddled bread with bacon and eat it. Knowing Elvis, bacon was on it every time, although some accounts state not. There's another variation that states it was fried, was dunked in egg wash, or dunked in egg like cream, French toast, after the whole sandwich was assembled and then fried. But I believe those are all kind of like some chef come up with that and said, oh, this is what Elvis had when he was at my restaurant. Well, it may not be so. So I'm going to do it to the best of the best of the best. I got some Burger Smokehouse original country bacon. Gonna fry that off in the oven. Real easy to do. Set your oven for 350. Lay your bacon flat on a bacon sheet. You put foil on your bacon sheet to make it easier to clean up. And bake it till it smells ready, which is about 15 minutes. And it stays flat, it don't curl all up and have some rough spots in places and pieces. And you just gotta watch you don't burn it. Let me get that dig. Something I noticed about Burger's Smokehouse bacon products, every piece is sliced consistently as far as thickness is concerned. Sometimes you buy bacon and some pieces are paper thin, you can see through the damn thing. And some pieces will be thicker than others, and it's just sloppy slicing. Y'all need to tighten up, boy. That's non-union as hell. When you buy bacon and it just slop sliced. Sloppily sliced. With a whole lot of shaking going on. A boy. Yeah. Alright, y'all want a full-length video. Full-length video. Look, bacon. Sheet, oven, preheat 350. Nah, ain't gonna cook. Yeah, well, what would my version of an Elvis sandwich be? If I had to make one up, I think I'd fry it in bananas. Take them and slice them down long ways and fry them with some butter and some rum. Garlic? Nah, I better not do that. But that ain't traditional. That's not what Elvis, the way he ate it. It's way some claim that they made it, but that's not. We'll make it traditional, Elvis style. Cook up some, couple pieces of bread, and just on a skillet. Look, clean stove, First call, first seat in a while, huh? You gonna butter this, put two pieces of sliced bread on there, and toast it. Preheating the iron pan. I got all kind of cast iron cookwares. We're gonna use this one because it's out. Buttering said warming pan. Easy, huh? Adding fresh bread to said pan. Let's let him toast. Got butter on the finger, lick it. Yum. I had a butter finger. Bacon's done. Let's get him out and drain it. It's still hot too. Just flip the bread over. I think it's ready for peanut butter. Over here, boy, over here, camera boy. Just pull that bread and peanut butter and jelly it. All right. Choosy moms choose Jeff. Yeah. Read a write up on those all natural peanut butters and all that. Yeah. Taste test. They were voted taste wise. So use the real deal. I like creamy Jif. You will too. A boy. Plus that's what I got. Look, now I got peanut butter on my finger. Yum. It's even more like a butt finger, huh? Let's get some jelly on here too. I stand corrected, it's jam. Jam up, baby. Jam up. And jelly time. Ooh, my mama, bubba, bubba, you're out of sight. Something like that, huh? Yeah, yeah. I know it. I should have been in Nashville, huh? Got that fancy footwork, too. Look at that. Shake, shake. Whole lot of shaking. Blue suede shoe. Bullshit. Down here, camera boy. Put as much or as little as you like. Now, we got to put the bacon on there. And you know I'm gonna have to save a piece of this bacon. Just for general principles. That's enough for the sandwich, huh? Unless you want bacon that high, then you eat it. See how it keeps your arteries lubed up. Lubricates your heart valves, too. Good form. Oh, hell yeah. Damn. Jam drip off. Just missed my foot. Look, I'm serious. See the jam down there? Now I don't have to kiss my foot. You can. Good plan, JB. Yum. Put the banana on there. All right, full length video, full length video. Watch me peel a banana. Gonna use half of it. Cause that's what Elvis mama said, boy. So, slicing the banana slightly on the bias, rather thinly, with an old dull steak knife. Now, applying said banana that was sliced slightly on the bias on said sandwich. Oops. We'll give that one to Chiquita, our banana dog. Now, one, Elvis sandwich. There you go. You like that? You could cut it in half again, quarter it, and make a big old stack. Yum! There's also a sandwich that some restaurant in Nevada, or Colorado, one, invented for him. It's called a Fool's Gold sandwich. And it was a piece of a whole French bread with a whole stick of butter on it, warmed and up at crisp on the outside in the oven. With that butter melted all over it, and they cut it in half and hollowed out the inside of it, a whole pound of bacon, a whole jar of peanut butter, and a whole jar of grape jelly went in. Sandwich. There's some other history about the Fool's Gold sandwich. You can read about that online, where Elvis ordered 22 of them and ate a lot of them in one night. The other day, I ain't had no beer yet. I lied, I had one. I made a quick and easy chicken and dumplings. I didn't shoot a video because I shot one back in January of this year, just using cream of chicken soup. Added a little bit of cream to that. A little small can of the canned biscuits. Roll them out thin and slice them into strips. Throw them in the soup and cream mixture with a little bit of water. And I cooked some chicken boneless thighs in the oven. And fried a few also. I took them and sliced them into turds, like the one thigh that's been boned and filleted. It's been boned. Butter? Bone? Oh. Boner? No. Where was I? Yeah. So the skinless, boneless thighs, you lay them out and cut them into three pieces each. I baked some in the oven and then fried some in a pan that were chicken, battered like fried chicken, and put the ones that were baked in the oven in the soup mix and set the fried ones around the side Did I make some cornbread too? I don't know if I pictured that. I know I had some cornbread muffins too, but anyway, I did a video at the beginning of the year. I'll put a link in the description box of this video for that one. A boy, a girl. If you like what you see on my channel, please subscribe, give me a thumbs up, a bye.